Hey guys, my name is Dr. Sam. Today I wanted to talk all about measuring your blood pressure at home and give you some simple tips along the way. Let me tell you a true story. I was looking after a young guy who was taking part in a heart study, and he was my age actually at the time, and he had very high blood pressure, which was difficult to control with medications. One morning he came in to see me with severe chest pain, and I knew straight away that something was dreadfully wrong. I thought he might be having an aortic dissection, which is when the main artery of the body splits and is an extremely serious condition. In the end, he did have a dissection and we admitted him to hospital straight away. Thankfully, he managed to survive. This event scared me a great deal, and that week I went out and bought my own home blood pressure monitor. Now, high blood pressure is one of those insidious problems, and that often you feel completely normal and it can go on for a long time before it is picked up or it causes illness. And having a high blood pressure in your body is like having high pressure in water pipes. Over time, it causes little tiny nicks in the walls of blood vessels, like in your brain, kidneys, heart, backs of the eyes. And when it damages them, it can lead to more serious health problems like strokes, heart disease, heart failure, atrial fibrillation, kidney disease, and cognitive decline. I personally like to have as much control over my health as possible, so I strongly encourage you to get your own home blood pressure monitor as well, especially if you're someone who doesn't like to visit the doctor. If you are in your 40s, 50s, and 60s, yes, I'm talking to you. It's also great if you have started blood pressure medications and your doctor is increasing your dose, and you can check things yourself without needing to visit them every couple of weeks. Of course, if you don't want to buy one, there are other ways, like seeing a doctor or getting it checked at a pharmacy, but I like the convenience of having my own blood pressure monitor just to keep an eye on things myself. So are home blood pressure monitors any good? Actually, yes. Research has shown that validated home blood pressure monitors are useful, especially if patients have white coat hypertension, which is when your blood pressure goes up from being around medical people or having procedures done. In fact, home blood pressure readings are found to be 5 to 10 millimeters of mercury lower than clinic-based measurements. Also, nowadays, they aren't as expensive as they used to be. I picked up my one on special for about $90 and I got it from my local pharmacy. So what should you look for in a home monitor? Right, there are a few things to know. Firstly, I tend to recommend getting one that has an arm cuff, so one that measures your blood pressure from your brachial artery. And the reason is that these tend to give more reliable readings than a wrist or finger monitor. But you have to get the right cuff size for your arm. So if you have very large arms, then maybe a validated wrist device is a better choice. Brands. I'm not actually affiliated with any particular brand, but I do like Omron, and that's what I bought myself and then made my mum buy one too. I'll link a great website for you in the description that lists independently validated blood pressure monitors for home use if you want to compare some different brands yourself. Next up, how should you use it? Now, I'm sorry if I'm telling you how to suck eggs here, but I think the next lot of information I'm going to explain is really crucial, so just bear with me. The whole idea behind blood pressure monitoring is to identify trends and to minimize mistakes in how you measure your blood pressure. Firstly, I'd recommend to take your blood pressure before breakfast and before taking any medicines. And I'm not sure what your usual routine is, but say you get up in the morning, go to the toilet, then just sit down in a comfortable chair for about 5 minutes and try to think relaxing thoughts. Keep both of your feet flat on the floor and put the cuff on your bare arm at about the level of your heart. Then push the button to start the inflation. Once it's done a reading, wait about a minute and check it again, and keep a record of the readings by each day. I often get asked by my patients, how many times a day should I check my blood pressure? Honestly, I think once a day is plenty, but some doctors request evening measurements, especially if you are taking twice daily blood pressure tablets. How many times a week should you measure your blood pressure? Again, this will depend on what is happening in your life. So if you have bought one to keep an eye on your blood pressure, but you aren't on any meds and you are pretty well, I'd check it once every 6 months. If you are starting medications or your doctor is changing your medications, they may want you to take measurements each day for a week. What do the numbers mean? Okay, let me give you my crash course in interpreting the readings. It really isn't as scary as people think. So you have two numbers for a blood pressure. One is called the systolic pressure, which is the top number. This is how much pressure your blood puts onto your artery walls when the heart beats. Then the bottom number is called diastolic blood pressure, which is how much pressure there is on your arteries when your heart is resting between beats or relaxed. Now the top number should always be bigger than the bottom number. And I tend to focus more on the top number, but actually they are both important. So what is a high blood pressure home reading? Well, technically it's a number of more than 135 systolic or 85 diastolic. And if we're talking about treatments, I have some ballpark figures in my mind that I use for my patients. If you have a blood pressure of more than 180 systolic or 110 diastolic plus symptoms, which can be blurred vision, headaches, seizures, confusion, weakness, nausea and vomiting, chest pain or shortness of breath, you must go into hospital for treatment. This is called malignant hypertension and is a serious condition. If you have a blood pressure of more than 160 over 100, usually I'd start blood pressure medication straight away. Often it's quite hard to bring down your levels naturally at this point, but in saying that, some people do manage this with weight loss or exercise. If you have a blood pressure of more than 135 over 85, but also have other risk factors like diabetes, high cholesterol, smoking, there's actually a whole bunch of risks I'll list in the description for you, then I'd normally encourage you to see your own doctor for a full checkup and blood panel. Regardless of what your reading is, I think it's better to know what is going on under the hood than being in the dark about your blood pressure. For myself, I love being able to measure my own blood pressure when I want to, in the comfort of my own home. It's definitely helped me take control back over my own health. So give this video a like if you enjoyed it, hit the subscribe button for new videos every single week, and hit the bell to get notified when I post new videos on Tuesdays. Please let me know in the comments what you enjoyed about this video or what you'd like to learn more about. Feel free to check out some of my other videos on medications. Thanks so much for watching.